Blackstone presents The Sentinel by Walt Robillard. This book is read by Joe Hempel. Prologue. Halicos Moon, Planet Camulon, Core Worlds Alliance. Dr. Shindoa Cote risked a peek behind her shoulder at the two hulking troopers occupying the bulk of the real estate at the back of the elevator. They wore black-mirrored visors that allowed for none of their features to be clear to the naked eye. In the center was a red upside-down triangle that moved slightly with the trooper's head movements. A noise in an atmosphere vent here, a tick in a support strut of the plate decking there. The triangle would zip in line with the noise. If she had to guess, their height and overall build would have to make them Vosi. Red-skinned giants from the world of Chimera, they were once the most aggressively expanding empire in the Alliance. A calamity on their world ended their reign, forcing them to chase their former glory ever since. It was strange to be smaller than those she encountered. Cote was a Zobon, an insectile race typically over 2.5 meters tall. Her forearms were cupping an assortment of items she hustled together on her way out of the Skytram. Trying to keep hold of everything she was carrying gave her a hunched appearance that made her look even smaller than her two guards. "Would you mind?" Cote asked through the translator collar around her neck. She handed a case to one of the guards who took it in an outstretched hand. The doctor casually let a finger brush his hand, causing the triangle on its visor to shift position for a fraction of a second. She rearranged the bags over her shoulders, making better use of her frame, finally accepting the box from the guard her extrasensory abilities hinted at being a bot. Dr. Cote felt she'd present a more confident expression if her personal items weren't falling out around her. It wasn't every day a covert team in finely tailored suits and sunglasses came to your classroom to ask you for your assistance. That they worked for Triton Expeditionary wasn't lost on her either. She'd heard rumors that some of her colleagues had been scooped up by the covert agency's constantly hungry R&D department. Most would attend academic events and conferences to show off the heaps of money they were being paid to do the work she was doing as an educator. Cote was hoping this would be her chance to get into the big leagues, or possibly even get a huge research grant. The doors slid open, exposing her to a busy lab atmosphere of monitors, technicians, and working projects. Cote wafted from the lift, trying to figure out the amount of lifetimes she would have to work in order to have a lab this lavish. Standing at an observation window was a small gaggle of humans. One of them she recognized immediately. Camden Haas, Director of Research and Development for Coda Industries. He was wearing a lab coat over a set of pants that probably cost more than her monthly salary. And don't get her started on the shoes. Human clothes were so extravagant. "Dr. Cote, a pleasure to meet you. 2407, please unburden the doctor so we may greet her properly." The massive mech took her belongings, looking utterly ridiculous carrying her two shoulder bags, even if they were all the rage in the coral this season. "Dr. Cote, did I say your name correctly?" "Yes, sir, Mr. Haas. In Trade 2, it's pronounced like the garment coat. Since humans don't use the ultrasonic clicks or pheromones of my race, saying it like this is good enough." "Excellent. How was your trip?" Shindoa adjusted her translation collar, trying to affect the mannerism of a human adjusting their tie. She had seen that having these minor tics put some humans at ease, and she tried to implement them whenever she could. "My trip was exciting. I'd never been on a military transport before. The accommodations were somewhat scant, but I didn't mind as I got to look around the vessel." Both Haas and the associate who had joined him seemed genuinely pleased at her enjoyment of things they most likely took for granted. She placed her top two hands across her chest, a Zobon symbol for a smile to those cultures that couldn't detect their strange emotional cues. "May I introduce my friend, Malachi Norris?" Haas said. "He's here representing the Triton Expeditionary Service." "I've read your paper on translocation among second sight-enabled species," Norris told her. "It was inspirational how members of the Cursati were able to use the unseen to cure members of the Jigen suffering from Dagidon's disease. That level of control over the universe is amazing." Shindoa clasped both sets of hands, a signal for joy.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.